everyone, and welcome to Senior Living. We've got a lot in store for you on this week's episode, and we thank you for joining us. We're going to get some information about the Great Chili Cook-Off in Sedona. We're also going to find out what we can expect at the Merchant Showcase in the Cornville area. We've got some great entertainment by the Old Time Fiddlers Association. That's kind of exciting. We're really glad to have them on the show. But our first guests are, their claim to fame is, if you want to call it that, that they are helping families across the world and around the corner. And we are very excited to be able to find out, get a little bit more information about the Kids Against Hunger organization. Our guests today are Karen Freeman. She's the director of the Kids Against Hunger Verde Valley, and Chief Jerry Dirksen with the Verde Valley Fire District.
That's Assistant Chief.
Assistant Chief, excuse me. And they are here today to give us some information. Kids Against Hunger was originally founded. The process began in about 1974, and from that time it has grown to this enormous, tremendous, amazing humanitarian effort throughout the world. The one thing that that we have here is a satellite of the Kids Against Hunger National Organization, and a satellite is where food gets packaged to be sent around the world. Not only does it get sent around the world, but it gets sent around the corner and used right here. We are coming up on some great events, but first I wanted to find out a little bit. Karen, you told me the story. I want you to tell everyone the story about how this satellite got started.
Well, my good friend Kim Gould, who's a local nurse practitioner here in the Verde Valley, had been going for several years and invited me to go post-earthquake. We went in May 2010 to a place she'd been ministering to called Jubilee, Haiti. And she was part of running medical clinics there under a couple called Emery and Mary Wilson, who had gone on a trip there, came home, sold everything they owned, went back and opened a school and an orphanage there. So she invited me to go in May. There's no way you can prepare for a trip like that, but we went, and we were working in the medical clinics there, and then in the middle of the day we would stop and do a feeding program. And they only had enough rice to feed 150 kids a day. And there were hundreds and hundreds of children lined up outside, orphans most of them. They had barely clothes, usually didn't have a place to live, no food, hadn't eaten, no water, no shade, and stood out there. And we only had enough rice to feed 150 kids a day. So that was really eye-opening to me. And this other thing, this dirt cookie, this is what mothers, if you're a mother and you've got children and you have nothing to feed them, they're scraping the dirt up off the ground, making clay cookies, baking them in the sun, and this is what they're doing to feed their children. So there's so many children there dying of starvation and many diseases secondary to malnutrition. So we couldn't do everything. We just couldn't not do nothing. So we came back and found out about Kids Against Hunger. We raised enough money to become the first food packaging satellite in Arizona, Kids Against Hunger, Verde Valley, under our umbrella organization called Manzanita Outreach, which is our medical arm. Mm-hmm. I oversee the food packaging part of it. So that's kind of how we got started.
And again, there are so many pictures on the website, which everyone's seeing at the bottom of their screen, but kahverdevalley.com. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. There's some photographs on there that are phenomenal. It's an amazing effort. Packaging satellite. Mm-hmm. What are we doing?
That? Okay. Basically, we, as a food packaging satellite, we're affiliated with Kids Against Hunger International, who has developed a food product that consists of rice, soy, vitamins and minerals, and kind of what we call the secret sauce. And that package right there that you're holding up feeds six. And for the price of 25 cents a meal, basically allows us to purchase the bulk food from the national office, have it shipped here, and then pays for our packaging, like the bags, the boxes, mm-hmm. and then for our shipping to Haiti. So what we do is we encourage people to fundraise, to be part of our effort at 25 cents a meal, and come and actually hands-on. We set it up for them. They actually are able to hands-on come and package the food. So that we take there.
Mm-hmm. this package of food, which you described earlier, is similar to a rice-a-roni type thing.
It is.
Except that it has soy, rice, vegetables, and all the nutrients that they need for a day.
Yep.
So in addition to not tasting too doggone bad,
it doesn't.
It's very nutritious.
Right. Right.
So I know that there have been several packaging events mm-hmm. that we have had here in the Verde Valley so far. Next up?
Well, we've actually, since we started in 2011, we've packaged over 92,000 meals and through various packaging events. And Jerry's going to tell you about one that's upcoming. That,
all right.
That anyone in the Verde Valley, it's an event that anyone from ages 10 up to 100 or older, if they'd like, could come and be involved. So,
yeah, we when we were talking about this event, I was got to thinking about Verde Valley Fire District, our combination together with the Cornville Community Association, and we've done so many things: the Pink Heels tours, the Easter egg hunts that they do every year. We've raised money for AEDs. We've raised money for sending boxes across the nation, and not just Cornville, but all over the Verde Valley Fire District. Mm-hmm. And so Cornville Community Association said, let's get together and let's see if we can do this. So what we're looking for is we want to raise enough funds, and that's enough funds is over $1,700 to have 44 people, and if 44 people raise $40 each, then we can package over 7,000 meals, and we're planning on doing that on May the 12th. We're going to do it at the fire station from 10 a.m. until noon, and the drive is going well. We've gotten almost $900 right now, and we're still needing that other $700, $800 to be able to finish up.
So a few things that people should keep in mind. May 12th, Verde Valley Fire Station, people are still needed to help raise funds. And like you said, at $40 a person, that goes a long ways. But the people to physically be there and help package, it's not extremely stressful, but there are also some other ways that they can help out during the event. You get several children that come in and help, or younger people that come in and help. Mm-hmm. And people can help keep them occupied and keep them busy and supervise if packing is something that they can't do. I think that it's also important to note, when we said you're helping families around the world mm-hmm. and around the corner, mm-hmm. what happens at the end of the day after the packaging event, the packaging itself is done?
At the end of the day, when we finish that packing, one of the rules for Kids Against Hunger is 15% of that stays locally. And so, or if they wanted to, if that group wants to send it all to wherever that is, they can do that. But with Cornville, what we want to do is we want to take 15% of that and take that to the food bank that's right across the street. So we'll walk right across the street with that and be able to take that there that day. And these here are help our community in mm-hmm. multiple ways. There's six different food banks, is it?
That right now, uh-huh.
That accept this and give this out on a regular basis. It goes in backpack programs, so mm-hmm. kids can be able to take it home and have food. It's amazing that if you really study it, the meals that they give out at schools and the programs there, those are sometimes the only meals that those kids get.
Yep. Right.
And so this allows them to be able to have meals over the weekends as well, too, and then down at the
Riverfront Park. They do a feeding program, so.
Right.
Yeah.
There's so much more than we can possibly discuss on the show, which is why you need to go to KAHverdeValley.com, get some more information, contact these great people. You can make a difference yeah. around the world and around the corner, and we invite you to do that. Stay tuned. We're going to be right back to find out more about the Great Sedona Chili Cook-Off, and after this break, we'll see you back here.
The Vaughn Law Offices in Cottonwood have been serving the legal needs of Northern Arizona since it was established in the year 2000. With experience in legal matters from criminal and civil courtroom litigation to corporate and personal, the attorneys and staff use their core values to support their clients through any legal situation. Visit online at vaughn-law.com to learn more about the Vaughn Law Offices, a proud supporter of the Verde Valley community.
If you're looking for a new pet that your family will cherish every day, consider adopting from a shelter. Shelters are the best places to find a new pet. That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals, eager to become a part of your family. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. So bring home your new buddy today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
Now, some action from the courts. Billie Jean King renewing her rivalry with arthritis. First set, furious volley, and right to the net for a winner. Beautiful forehand there. Arthritis, stunned. And here, match point. Billie Jean with the ace, taking it in straight sets. Afterwards, a jubilant Billie Jean King.
Tennis is a weapon for me with arthritis. There's nothing like it for me to hit a ball, run to the ball, anytime, any court. I'm ready. Let's go.
What's your weapon against arthritis? Find out at fightarthritispain.org.
Welcome back. Thanks for coming back and joining us. Again, so much at springtime, and there are a lot of events going on in the Verde Valley. And one that's been going on for some time now, and it's got some history to it, is the Great Sedona Chili Cook-Off. Our guest to tell us a little bit more about that is Catherine Moore. Catherine,
Hi.
You are with the Rotary Club of Sedona.
Rotary Club of Sedona, yeah.
Tell us a little bit about the history of the Chili Cook-Off. It's been going on for how long?
This is only the second year that we've done it.
Okay.
So it doesn't have a great history, but it's getting a great reputation.
I've read
Last
a lot about
year
it.
Was really wonderful. It was at Talaki Paki, and we only had 7 restaurants, and this year we're going to have 12.
So, I'll mention a few of the restaurants. Bodacious Burgers, that's a new restaurant
it
in
is.
Sedona.
Uh-huh.
El Rincon, Mesa Grill, Oak Creek Brewing Grill, Red's, Redstone Grill and Patio, Renee, Renegades, the Secret Garden Cafe, Westside Deli, Zanies, and the Verde Valley School.
Mm-hmm.
That's very exciting.
It is.
Is it outdoors at Talaki Paki?
It's outdoors in the Calle de Independencia, which is right there in the center of Talaki Paki, so we're going to have lots of room, and we have a beer garden, our very own beer garden this year, and Oak Creek Brewery is going to be doing that, so and supplying all the beer for us. So everybody's just been so generous. It's just been an incredible thing.
And there is admission for this, correct?
There is admission. It's $10 for adults, and children under 10 are free.
Great.
So, and there's 3-ounce tastings, and so you have a chance to eat about 2.5 pounds of chili, I think, if you...
So the admission gets you 3-ounce tastings from any or all of these 12
from participating? All of these 12. We're asking people to just take one tasting from each to make their ballot selection for people's
right.
choice, and then later on in the event, if everybody's got lots of chili left over, then people could go back for seconds.
Great.
But if you have a tasting from every restaurant, you're probably going to be full.
Yeah, I'm going to think so. On one of the graphics, I guess there's going to be different spice levels from mild to...
You know, it's kind of up to the restaurants to do whatever they want. Last year we had some vegetarian, and we had all different kinds. We had rattlesnake meat, I think somebody did that, and then one person did all kinds of game, like elk and venison mixed in. So it's whatever, they can get very creative.
Excellent.
Yeah.
And there's a People's Choice Award.
Yeah, actually this is the... award for the judges chili. We're
this
having
is the
a
judges
panel
award.
Of judges.
Okay.
We have a panel of judges. We have the fire chief and the police chief and the mayor are our judges. And so this is the traveling trophy. This is a traveling trophy. Last year El Rincon won it. It's a handcrafted chili made by Richard Barnwell, who's a artist, and he's actually very involved in the cook-off.
That is a substantial trophy, I will tell
it
you.
It is. It is. Yeah.
Excellent. So there is a People's Choice, and then there is a
Judge's Choice.
Okay.
And then there's also a Best Booth for Best Booth decoration this year, too.
So with 12 of them, that's going to be pretty exciting, and you've got the event located at Talaki Paki, which
mm-hmm.
in and of itself is a great
right.
place for
and
an outdoor
event. And also, it's on Cinco de Mayo, which means 5th of May, it's
mm-hmm.
a Saturday. It's actually on the day this year, so Cinco de Mayo is on Cinco de Mayo. And it's part of the event at Tlaquepaque, which has mariachis and ballet folklorical and all kinds of things going on for children, piñatas and things going on.
And a little chili and a little cerveza and a little shopping.
See?
The day is the day is pretty well rounded out.
Right.
You are with the Rotary Club of Sedona.
Yes.
And this is a fundraiser for the Rotary
Club? This is a fundraiser.
Okay.
It's our main fundraiser that we are doing, you know, for the year.
Mm-hmm.
And the main beneficiaries of it are In Polio Now, which people might have seen that in airports and things. There's a big campaign to eradicate polio in the entire world.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really happy to say there's only 3 countries in the whole world left that are still endemic for polio. Rotary's been working on this for since 1985, and we're just this close. So we're a big chunk of the money will go for that, and the rest is going to Imagination Library, which is our new local project. Rotary is a service club, but we do local things and also international things. So the In Polio Now is what we're just about finished with on an international scale, and then now that's not just our club, that's Rotary clubs all over the world.
Correct.
Of which there's 33,000 of them.
Right.
But and then the Imagination Library is a program to send a book every month to preschool children, and so that should really help literacy. It was actually started by Dolly Parton and has had great success in other parts of the country, so we're going to start to do it here.
Well, all of these things, we know how involved Rotary Club is in all of our communities.
Yeah.
We've got a lot of participation throughout the entire Verde Valley Sedona area. So those, I don't want to sound like taking it for granted, but we know what great work the Rotarians do in terms of service to our community. So to be able to, again, enjoy some great chili and some great fun, on what will hopefully be a good weather day,
good weather day.
Exactly.
My genies, I have good weather genies, and I'm counting on them.
You bet. What else is coming up for Rotary Club? You said this is your major fundraiser. Are there other events that you normally do throughout the year?
Well, we just are planning another event at Tlaquepaque. Actually, Wendy Lippman of Tlaquepaque is really generous, and we're planning a Day of the Dead event in November. And but that's, we don't have that planned yet, and we haven't done that before. We've done something called New Year's All Year Round because we were very interested in different cultures and trying to find out about them. We've done a Thai dinner and something with on Jewish New Year and different New Years in different parts of the world. And this one is going to be a Day of the Dead event. So.
Excellent. People can go to, you have a calendar on SedonaRotary.org? Is that the website? Yeah, SedonaRotary.org.
That's right.
And,
I had to think about that. I never look up. www.SedonaRotary.org. Yep.
Right. Check out the calendar on the website. Keep informed on what's going on. Again, providing great services to the community and great fun to
great
all of
fun.
Us that get to take advantage of it.
We do a lot of good things. We do highway cleanup. There's a lot of things that we do, but we also have a lot of fun.
Sounds like it.
Yeah.
Catherine, thank you
thank
for being
you
here.
So much.
Don't forget May 5th, Tlaquepaque, and we'll all have a great time. I'm quite sure of it. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back to talk about the Merchant Showcase in Cornville. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Ben Bueller, owner and funeral director at Bueller Funeral Homes. My grandfather once told me, you can serve a family selfishly once, or treat them right and serve that family for generations.
Bueller Funeral Home has been serving Arizona families for 3 generations with affordable and reasonable services. Bueller Funeral Home feels a funeral should be as unique and personal as the individual it honors, whatever your choices, your traditions, or your budget.
Now, some action from the courts. Billie Jean King renewing her rivalry with arthritis. First set, furious volley, and right to the net for a winner. Beautiful forehand there. Arthritis, stunned. And here, match point. Billie Jean with the ace, taking it in straight sets. Afterwards, a jubilant Billie Jean King.
Tennis is a weapon for me with arthritis. There's nothing like it for me to hit a ball, run to the ball, anytime, any court. I'm ready. Let's go.
What's your weapon against arthritis? Find out at fightarthritispain.org.
Two outs with a runner on first base. Now the big guy comes up again, hitting 342 with 92 RBIs and 36 homers.
Chill raw and prepared foods promptly. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Well, welcome back. We are glad you stayed tuned. We are moving right along today, and we have a little bit of Cornville flavor going on. Right now, we're going to talk with Debbie Siegel. She's with the Cornville Community Association, among other things. But they have coming up, once a year, they do a merchant showcase. And with Cornville growing the way it is, it's always exciting to see what businesses are blossoming and are really thriving in that Cornville area. Debbie, welcome back. I know
Thanks,
you've been
Pam.
In before, but it's nice to have you here. First of all, the Cornville Community Association has been around for about 8 years?
Originally, it was organized back in the early 80s.
Oh, wow.
And somewhere along the line, it did really well for a while, and then they kind of lost their tax-exempt status, mm-hmm. or nonprofit status. And then in the early 2002, mm-hmm. they reorganized and rewrote their bylaws, became an official membership organization, and got their reincorporated.
Excellent.
And so then we published our community plan in 2005. We got mm-hmm. an award from the governor for that.
I do remember that.
Very exciting. We really use the community plan.
And it's been a model for other communities, if I'm not mistaken. The county and other counties have used it as a model. So.
They have. If you've never looked at it, it's beautiful. All kinds of illustrations and very cool things.
Absolutely. Several years ago, the association, and they are very active, not just in Cornville, but throughout the county. They stay very involved in all kinds of issues throughout the county. They began doing an annual merchant showcase. Mm-hmm. And this year, tell us about this year's event.
Okay, this is the third year that it's officially been called the Merchant Showcase. Previously, it was a Green Fair, mm-hmm. and people didn't understand what that was. So it's open to anyone who owns a business that operates in Cornville, or if you live in Cornville and have a business, and we have occasional ones that have their businesses located in Cottonwood, but they live in Cornville, so they're welcome to come. There's no cost to the merchant to participate, and there's no cost to the public to come and participate, and it's open, and we welcome. That's the whole point. The second Wednesday of May, so this year, May 9th, mm-hmm. and it's from 6 to 8 at the Oak Creek School in Cornville. The merchants will come, and they will display what they have to offer. Now, some of them will be offering samples. Last year, Randy from Manzanita was there, and we had wonderful samples.
That's reason enough to go right there, but
indeed.
I'm sure there's much more.
Oh, absolutely. We have a couple of authors. We have some photographers, somebody who does guitars, somebody who does sewing. So we have about a little over 20 people registered so far, and I'm getting one or two a day. Mm-hmm. So we hope to have between 30 and 40. And it was really, really a lot of fun. The merchants themselves didn't know each other. They're not necessarily in the same business. So mm-hmm. they got to meet a lot of people. And they got customers. And people got to find out what was going on.
I would imagine that with many of the merchants that are in Cornville, there are many more retail businesses than there were even just a couple of years ago, but many of them are service-oriented type businesses, so it's not that they can get to know their fellow merchants in Cornville because they're out working and doing what they need to do. So
yes.
It gives them an opportunity to sort of share information and get to know each other.
We have a lot of what you would call cottage industries. People in their own homes doing a little something or one little shop here or there. So you're right. There's not a lot of walk-by business mm-hmm. in Cornville. You have to know to come there.
Right.
But we have wonderful, wonderful things. We have salons and massage situations. We have some great restaurants for a tiny little town, or we're not a town. We're a place.
An incorporated community. Unincorporated community.
Right. But we have some excellent restaurants, the Manzanita and Harry's, and Page Springs restaurant is going to reopen called On the Creek, I think.
I didn't realize it was changing names, but I did hear that it was going through a little bit of a facelift and going to reopen.
Grasshopper Grill has new owners and they're reopened. Mm-hmm. And so there's lots of opportunities in Cornville. So.
I think there's, we have seen it grow. And I do remember when the community plan was done, the discussion about cottage industry and how huge it really is. And to have a merchant showcase that allows them to participate also helps out a lot, because you can't necessarily know that the person two houses down from you is a seamstress and one of the best in the area.
Exactly. So. Or somebody who can do your taxes without schlepping someplace.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
There, I have a list that I keep of all the businesses that I know of in Cornville, and it's over 150. So
that is amazing.
Who would even think?
You go Cornville, that's all right. So Cornville Community Association, is it tied into one of the meetings, or this is totally separate?
This is in place of our May meeting.
Okay. Cornville Community Association, do you have to reside in Cornville to belong to the association?
You either have to reside in Cornville or have a business that's located in Cornville.
Okay. Do you have associate memberships for those people that may want to be involved in the association, or not yet?
We do not at this time have anything but a membership.
Okay, all right. Cornville Community Association, if you do live in Cornville and you're able to watch this show, something you may want to check out if you haven't already. I know that every month the A-Frame signs are up to announce meetings, so you can't miss it. And the Merchant Showcase, May 9th.
Correct.
Oak Creek School, 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. They're hoping for 30 to 40 businesses, and trust me, you'll be glad that you checked them out if you can take the time to go. We are going to get to break here in just a moment, and we're going to come back. Again, lots going on in the Verde Valley. May 12th is the Primetime Fair, and I'm sure you'll want to hear a little bit more about that. Stay tuned.
The Vaughn Law Offices in Cottonwood have been serving the legal needs of Northern Arizona since it was established in the year 2000. With experience in legal matters from criminal and civil courtroom litigation to corporate and personal, the attorneys and staff use their core values to support their clients through any legal situation. Visit online at vaughn-law.com to learn more about the Vaughn Law Offices, a proud supporter of the Verde Valley community.
If you're looking for a new pet that your family will cherish every day, consider adopting from a shelter. Shelters are the best places to find a new pet. That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals, eager to become a part of your family. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. So bring home your new buddy today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
Chill raw and prepared foods promptly. 1 in 6 Americans will get sick from food poisoning this year. Keep your family safer. Check your steps at foodsafety.gov.
Welcome back to Senior Living. Thanks for staying with us. One of the things coming up is right up our alley, and we're really excited. It's time for the annual Primetime Fair. The Primetime Fair is put on primarily by the Chamber of Commerce, but with involvement from businesses throughout the community. This year's Primetime Fair is looking to be one of the best, and we're really excited. Our guests today are with the Chamber of Commerce, Lana Tallison, the president of the Chamber, Pam Miller, who is past president, and just involved in just about everything. No?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. That was a look. Of,
no.
Like I messed something up there. I'm
past
sorry.
Chair. Past chair.
Past
actually.
Past chair. Past chair.
She's our one and only president.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. I did mess something
That's
up.
Okay. That's okay.
That. All right. Welcome, ladies. Thanks for being here. We were talking about the Primetime Fair actually just earlier today, and how we're going to be involved, and we're looking forward to it. Tell us, start off with all of the logistics, date, time, place.
The Primetime Fair will be held at Tavasi Elementary on Saturday, May 12th from 9 to 1 p.m., and it is a free event for seniors.
Excellent, excellent. We were there last year,
yes,
and there were so many people. It was really exciting, and that one was a little, I had only been to the American Heritage School a few times, and so that was a little bit, I didn't know, and it was so crowded. It was a huge success. So this year, I'm sure it's going to be every bit as big, if not bigger. How many vendors, how many merchants do you have this year?
Well, we're looking to have around 60 vendors.
Okay, and you're still taking?
We're still in the process of signing vendors up.
Excellent.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Excellent. Great. So what kinds of things might I expect to be able to check out while I'm there?
You want to take this one?
The vendors are, we have our major sponsor mm-hmm. is Verde Valley Medical Center.
Right.
And they will have a large array of representation there. Usually they have something with hip replacement, their cardio. So we're really glad that they have chosen again to be our presenting sponsor.
Lots of subjects that the senior population might be interested in. Will they do things like have blood pressure checks there? Will they actually be doing any of those kinds of things, or informational only?
I am not sure that they will have the blood pressure checks there.
Mm-hmm.
It's more informational.
Perfect.
We do have a hearing aid. Mm-hmm. Companies mm-hmm. represented, and some of those will be doing hearing tests. We have the couple of the attorneys for estate planning.
Mm-hmm.
So there's all kinds of information for senior assistance and mm-hmm. Like assisted living and in-home care, and just mm-hmm. a lot of variety on issues that are related to seniors.
Another one of our sponsors is NACOG.
Oh, that's right. They're a world of resources right mm-hmm. there by themselves. I also remember last year several businesses. One that I particularly checked out was the automatic blinds that you can put on your back porch, or the just things for around your house that people might need to, as they start thinking about not having to do so much physical work themselves, that vendors that might be able to help them out with that.
There will be other businesses that have items that would be of value to seniors.
Mm-hmm. What else do we need to know about it?
What else can we tell her? Free parking,
mm-hmm.
free admittance, lots of door prizes.
We will have entertainment.
Are we having donuts again first thing in the morning?
No donuts this year.
Okay.
No donuts.
That's probably a better thing. I just remember last year there were donuts.
Trying to keep it a little healthy.
That is a good thing. That is a good thing. Will there be food available since it is 9 to 1? Is there some?
There is food available.
Okay.
We do want to share how to get to Tavasi Elementary School.
Please do.
When you're going out of town, you go right on 260 and then right on Del Rio, and it's at the end of the Del Rio.
Yep.
Run right into the school.
Basically, if you're coming over from Camp Verde, from any direction, you hit Del Rio and head till it, now that direction I'm going to have a problem with. Towards the mountain, towards Mingus Mountain, and head to
yes,
the end of
yes,
the
yes.
end of the road, and you'll run right into the school. So that'll be great. Again, that is Saturday, May 12th, 9 a.m. to 1 p.m., Tavasi Elementary School. There will be hopefully 60 vendors that will be able to provide you with information from medical to legal to home health care, mm-hmm. all of those kinds of things. There will be a lot of different vendors in terms of things that you might need around the house. Again, it's just a wealth of information for all of us. And Cottonwood Chamber has been involved in so many things recently, and so many great opportunities around the community. What else is on the calendar of events for the chamber?
Well, we have our annual golf tournament. We'll have the regional mixer where all five chambers come together. We'll have a home and business expo in September. Mm-hmm. So that'll be another great event where businesses can be showcased. Mm-hmm. We have our monthly mixers where businesses get to mix and mingle, mm-hmm. and meet each other and network. Mm-hmm. And of course there's Verde River Days, Rhythm and Ribs in October. There's lots and lots of activities, and we try to do everything we can to promote all the businesses in the Verde Valley, and Cottonwood in particular, to try to help bring a little life and a little economic success.
Well, and I think that's what we're all about, helping each other mm-hmm. keep ahead of all of this. And I think that it's working, and you guys are working very hard at it. I know it will. It's right around the corner. The first annual Painted Barrel auction. And that's very exciting to
yes.
see that actually. And I'm starting to hear about the new barrels that are going to be, that we'll be commissioning to have them done for the next year. So that's very exciting. Lots coming up. Don't forget, we've mentioned this several times as we've talked about various events. There are a lot of volunteer opportunities available with the chamber. You don't have to be a business. You can be an associate member or a volunteer. And all you need to do is contact the chamber to find out how you can do that. And it's a great opportunity to get out there and mingle with our friends and neighbors. And I've heard, we've talked about this too, people that meet their neighbors for the very first time when they're volunteering on something that they have a like spirit for. So again, I want to thank Pam Miller and Lana Tollison. Appreciate you ladies coming down to talk about this. Yavapai Broadcasting and Verde Valley Television will be at the Primetime Fair, and we'd like for you to join us as well. We're going to take a short break, and we will be back right after that. Stay tuned.
If you're looking for a new pet that your family will cherish every day, consider adopting from a shelter. Shelters are the best places to find a new pet. That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals, eager to become a part of your family. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. So bring home your new buddy today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
Hi, I'm Ben Bueller, owner and funeral director at Bueller Funeral Homes. My grandfather once told me, you can serve a family selfishly once, or treat them right and serve that family for generations.
Bueller Funeral Home has been serving Arizona families for three generations with affordable and reasonable services. Bueller Funeral Home feels a funeral should be as unique and personal as the individual it honors, whatever your choices, your traditions, or your budget.
If you're looking for a new pet that your family will cherish every day, consider adopting from a shelter. Shelters are the best places to find a new pet. That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals, eager to become a part of your family. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. So bring home your new buddy today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
When you walk in Jerome, you never walk alone. 'Cause the ghosts dance all around you, all around you in Jerome.
Hi everyone, welcome back to Senior Living. We've talked many times about a lot of the different events going on in Jerome. We've talked about the wonderful history of Jerome, and today we get to visit Jerome.
We also get a little bit of a sneak peek at the 47th annual Jerome Home Tour, and it's the oldest, longest running home tour in the state of Arizona. Joining us today, we have the director of the tour, Colleen Hall. She's gonna be giving us a little bit of a fill-in about the tour itself, and the owner of our very first building that we're visiting, Mary Wills. Colleen, tell us about, first give us the dates and times of the actual home tour.
Okay, it's Saturday, May 19th, and Sunday, May 20th. The first tour starts off at 9 a.m. Mm-hmm. The last tickets are sold at 3 o'clock, and it's a continually running tour. You are not stuck with a tour guide or a certain group. The way it works is you buy your ticket, and you can buy it anytime between 9 a.m. and 3 o'clock. You get a wristband, and you get on our first shuttle, mm-hmm. and you stop off at our first stop, and get off, and spend as much time as you'd like to, as short or long a stay as you would like. We have docents at each of our venues, and they will give you the tour and give you history of the building, answer any questions that you may have. And when you're ready, you just go back outside, wait for the next shuttle to pick you up. It will pick you up and take you to the next venue.
So basically, you can spend all day up here. You can enjoy visiting a few homes, a few buildings, catch some lunch, get back on the bus, and continue the tour all day long.
Absolutely. Our visitors, some just decide to do the tour right through and then enjoy lunch afterwards. Some have gotten off and take a break. We do have restroom stops along the way. We have bottled water available for sale at each of the stops. We recommend, if I may say, the busiest day is Saturday.
Right.
So if you really want to avoid quite as many people, come on Sunday. And 9 o'clock is the very busiest time, both days.
For the 2 days.
Yes, you don't have to be here because you don't have to, there's no risk of not getting on the tour and doing the tour as long as you buy your ticket between 9 a.m. and 3 o'clock. We have no advance sales. They're only available the day of the event.
Good to know.
And the ticket sales are on Main Street, next to the police station and the old fire station, and there'll be mm-hmm. signs directing where the ticket sales are, and there's a lot of parking now in town. We have a 300 level, which is just past the fire station. There will be signs pointing to parking, and we run a shuttle all day back and forth from the parking area to the ticket sale area.
Great to know. That's great information. And we are standing in front of the Sullivan Hotel, which is one of the premier stops on the tour. And we are with one of the owners, Mary Wills, and your partner, Sally Dreyer. And tell us a little bit about the building, the history, and where you're headed with it.
Well, this is a building under construction. It's the Sullivan Hotel. It's the third building on the same site. It was built in the late 1800s. It was actually attached to the Cribs, another building which no longer exists. This particular wall was never intended to be exposed to the elements and was in failure. So we were in this building as tenants for 17 years and realized that the back wall was leaving the building. So that necessitated construction. This building being on the mountain, there are 4 floors on the back and 2 floors on the front. This is the second floor from the back, and you'll get to see a lot of it in construction. It was originally built by Jenny Bouders, who was a madam who came from Belgium and was thought to be one of the richest women in northern Arizona. This whole district was a red light district.
That's part of the charm of Jerome,
yes,
obviously. We really appreciate that part of the history. What are your plans here? There's a lot of renovation going on. We've gotten to see one of the almost completed steps, and that's the bathroom, which is absolutely amazing. Tell us a little bit more.
We're in the sixth year of destruction and construction, and we are going as money allows. We have recruited a master woodworker here from Montana, a gentleman named Stephen Gray, and he has built the bathroom, and it gives you just an example of his skill level. He's a master kaleidoscope maker and violin maker. So we're quite pleased to be able to show that off. The rest of the building is pretty much in construction, which you kind of, I think it's fun to see the in-between and the guts of a building. So that's what you'll get to see.
Mary, thanks for the great preview of the Sullivan Hotel. We're so happy to have gotten to preview this property. We're going to head over and we're going to get to preview the Kane Gillenwater home. And we want you to join us. Let's go. We've made it here to the Kane Gillenwater residence, and you will not believe the renovation on the inside of the house when you make it to the home tour. We're here with Donna Chesler. She is with the Town of Jerome home tour and PR for a lot of the different events. Tell us a little bit about this house.
Okay, this is called the Kane / Gillenwater home. The original owners were the Kane family, and James Kane worked at the mine, and he also was the mayor of Jerome. And he's well known for passing the ordinance for no spitting in the town of Jerome.
The only in Jerome.
Yeah. The Gillenwater family purchased the home in 1983, and they have enjoyed this home. They've done an amazing renovation, and there'll be a lot of stories that we're going to be telling about the hijinks of the Gillenwater family.
Donna, there's one other notable feature about this home. It is, you describe it best, it is the home closest to a major highway?
Yes. The home in Arizona, closest to 89A, and it is literally right on the road.
It is that. This is one of the additional homes. Not too far behind us is the Clark Street School, which is now the Town Hall and Library Complex. And right across the street is also the Deming Claggy Residence, which is another great stop on the home tour. What? Tell us a little bit about that one.
This home has been a total renovation of this home by the Claggy family. It started out on the 89A level as a one-level home, and they actually built down two other levels.
Wow.
And it's filled with wonderful Jerome art, and it's a real tribute to the art community here in Jerome and to wonderful owners who are willing to do such a great renovation.
Do want to remind you, Jerome is the most vertical town in Arizona. That means that this tour is not quite as handicap friendly as some of them may be. So keep that in mind. We remind you to leave your pets at home in the comfort of your home rather than dragging them around up here. And we'll see you on May 19th and 20th in Jerome.
Hi, I'm Ben Bueller, owner and funeral director at Bueller Funeral Homes. My grandfather once told me, you can serve a family selfishly once, or treat them right and serve that family for generations.
Bueller Funeral Home has been serving Arizona families for three generations with affordable and reasonable services. Bueller Funeral Home feels a funeral should be as unique and personal as the individual it honors, whatever your choices, your traditions, or your budget.
Now, some action from the courts. Billie Jean King renewing her rivalry with arthritis. First set, furious volley, and right to the net for a winner. Beautiful forehand there. Arthritis, stunned. And here, match point. Billie Jean with the ace, taking it in straight sets. Afterwards, a jubilant Billie Jean King.
Tennis is a weapon for me with arthritis. There's nothing like it for me to hit a ball, run to the ball, anytime, any court. I'm ready. Let's go.
What's your weapon against arthritis? Find out at fightarthritispain.org.
If you're looking for a new pet that your family will cherish every day, consider adopting from a shelter. Shelters are the best places to find a new pet. That's where you'll discover healthy, loyal, and loving animals, eager to become a part of your family. A person is the best thing to happen to a shelter pet. So bring home your new buddy today. To find out more, visit theshelterpetproject.org.
As I read the letter that you wrote to me, it's you that I am thinking of. And
as I read the line that to me was so dear, I remember our faded love. I miss you, darling, more and more every day, as heaven would miss the stars above. Think of the past and all the pleasures we had, as I watch the mating of the dove. It was in the springtime when you said goodbye. I remember our faded love. I miss you, darling, more and more every day, as heaven would miss the stars above. With every heartbeat I still think of you and remember our faded
so much. Ladies and gentlemen, Nancy Reynolds, ladies first, Maryland Sealing, Ray Sealing, Arizona Old Time Fiddlers Association, welcome to Senior Living. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Arizona Old Time Fiddlers Association. First of all, that is not just here in our very own little Verde Valley, it's throughout the state. Tell us a little bit about it.
That's right. We're an association that started in 1975 in Payson. And we have chapters in the Verde Valley, Prescott, Tucson, Yuma.
I saw some, I think, over in the Dewey area, right?
Yes. Prescott.
Yeah,
the,
okay, the whole,
Mile
that's
High.
The whole area.
Yeah,
okay.
That's where our Mile High chapter meets.
Oh, that's right. Mm-hmm.
Every third Sunday, we do a concert over there at the Orchards Ranch in Prescott Valley. And every first Sunday, we do a concert in Cottonwood at the Senior Center over on 6th Street and Cherry Street. And we go from 1 till 4 in the afternoon. Mm-hmm. Everybody's welcome. It's free. As you can see, we do fiddling and we do vocals and we do comedy sometimes. We just have a good time, and everybody is welcome to come.
Well, I know that, first of all, the Senior Center here does a great job of providing entertainment and things for us to do
throughout the week.
And I am just really happy to hear that you're one of the entertainers that's a regular over there. I think that's awesome. Now, you do go over to Prescott, and you play in the Prescott area?
Yes.
So as the Verde Valley chapter, you still participate with all the statewide events that go on?
Yes.
How fun!
And that includes campouts and various other things we do.
They have a bunch of down in Siloam. They do a bunch in Siloam and Yuma. They go all over the state and have big fiddle. They have one in Oahu every February that's a big fiddle championship.
Again, on the website, I saw all of the awards that are passed out annually, and that by itself seems like a lot of fun that you get to be recognized. And
yeah, we have a Hall of Fame.
Yeah, oh, that's right. Yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. that's the website has a lot of information about the organization as a whole.
It does. Look at our website, mm-hmm. ArizonaOldTimeFiddlers.org.
Mm-hmm. And we've been putting that up on the screen for people to check it out. Mm-hmm. More importantly, Senior Center here in Cottonwood. You've got your Prescott. What else? Are there other gigs that you do on a regular basis?
Well, every March we have a camp out in Cornville at this at the school.
Cornville School.
Oh, great.
That's a three-day mm-hmm. affair out there.
Mm-hmm.
And every August we have a camp out up in the woods
up by
near
Willard
Flagstaff.
Springs.
Oh, August. Okay, it's still nice enough then.
We also do we do things for the schools and for the seniors, and mm-hmm. we do charity things.
And play at rest homes. And
now, if an organization wanted to have you play at an event, would they just get a hold of you? Is it something
correct.
That you, there
yes.
are only certain things you can do, or you can
no.
do? Okay.
We're actually playing for Elaine for the senior thing. She's doing I guess it's like a work day where they can tell the seniors what's available in this area for them.
Oh,
and we're
okay.
going to go over and play at that. That's the May 12th at the Tavasi School.
Oh, that's at the Primetime Fair?
Primetime Fair.
Mm-hmm.
We just talked a little bit about the Primetime Fair. I'm going to be at the Primetime Fair.
We'll be
you guys
there.
Are going to be at the Primetime
we'll
Fair.
Be there.
Everybody else needs to be at the Primetime Fair on that Saturday and get to enjoy all of this. So any... aside from the campouts, and we know May 12th is an event where you'll be playing, do you have other, over the summertime there's usually quite a few things going on, do you have other events planned already that you're going to be playing at?
Well, yeah, we have a picnic coming up, I think, in September in Prescott.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that'll be in a park, in the Pioneer Park over there, is it?
Oh,
well, it's
right.
Memorial Day at John's place, too.
Yeah, Memorial Day will be at John Kennedy's
in Dewey.
Oh, okay.
Ranch out in Dewey.
All right.
That's an old-time fillers camp out type thing.
We've had contact information on the screen for these folks. They are available. If you're going to have a shindig, you might want to get in touch with them and see if they can come entertain at your shindig. We are thrilled to have them join us here on Senior Living. We're glad that you joined us on Senior Living. We want to first say thank you from Yavapai Broadcasting and Verde Valley Television. Want to invite you to join us every show. And while we say thanks and goodbye, we are going to listen to another song from the Arizona Old Time Fiddlers.
All right. We'll be right back.